Well, after a violent weekend, Baltimore police made an arrest in two murders last week. Now they're looking at ways to curb the recent uptick in crime. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey has more from police headquarters.
Baltimore police have seen an increase in both homicides and non-fatal shootings from this time last year, but they say they're encouraged by a quick arrest that got a violent offender off the streets.
23-year-old Isaac Truss faces a laundry list of charges, including first-degree murder, in two cases last week.
Homicide detectives caught up with him within hours after he committed his second murder in 24 hours, and he was arrested. He confessed to those murders. Ballistics matched.
Truss is charged for shooting a man to death inside a senior assisted living facility on Conway Street Thursday and for killing another man at a bus stop on Fayette Street early Friday morning. Police are looking at robbery as a motive in both cases. They say they identified Truss using City Watch camera footage and video from cameras inside the senior facility.
What we're looking very hard for now is, what else has this guy done in the last 20 years of his life? You don't just wake up one day and commit two murders in 24 hours. So detectives are working very hard right now. They're looking at robberies, they're looking at rapes, they're looking at anything that this individual might be connected to.
Those murders were just the start to a violent weekend in Baltimore. Shootings, stabbings, and more murders. Overall, the numbers for homicides and shootings are up since 2010, prompting the police commissioner to meet with district chiefs around the city Monday.
What we need to do is get a handle on some of the activities that are occurring, and I think the way to adjust it is more presence on the street, foot officers, and as the weather gets warmer, we want to increase interaction between police and the community.
As far as Isaac Truss is concerned, Baltimore police are asking if anyone recognizes him in connection with another crime to contact them. At police headquarters, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.